It's Britney, bitch.
It's Britney. I rented this car basically just so I could say that. But that's all I got. So I'm just going to keep going. Yep. Welcome to Casita Conejo. This is a two-story, 300-square-foot tiny home, and we are out here in Joshua Tree, California. It is another very windy day in the desert. This spot is actually owned by my friend Rob, aka Raw Built. He's also on YouTube. I'll put a link down to his channel in the video description. We met through YouTube and social media a couple years back, and we shot some videos at his place in Tennessee. Now he's a big shot Airbnb host and real estate investor, and one of my OG YouTube friends. Fun fact, back in 2020, when I just started out on YouTube, I had maybe 1,000 subscribers. I reached out to Rob for the first time and I pitched him to do a video shoot at this very house. And Rob rejected me. He said, and I quote, "I think I'm good." Well, Rob, only took me 3 years, but I'm now finally at your tiny home shooting a video. But seriously guys, all jokes aside, you're really going to love this spot. The layout feels like so much more than 300 square feet. I love how Rob designed this place. So without further ado, let's now go and start the full tour. Welcome to Casita Conejo out here in Joshua Tree. I was a huge fan of the front exterior of this home, especially all of the wood finishing, how it contrasts with the white paint job and blends into the desert surroundings perfectly. But we'll walk back, there's a little picnic table, and then an enclosed area with a bunch of string lights and a very nice hot tub. There's even a little viewing point here, and this points out straight towards sunset. Speaking of sunsets, this is what some of the surrounding area looks like. You're an easy 8-minute drive to the entrance to Joshua Tree National Park. But that's it for the exterior, so I'll open up the door and let's continue with the tour. When you first enter, you'll see your sofa there on the left and your dining area straight ahead. You have a small circular dining table and a big TV right above it. It is a smart TV, so you can go on YouTube and subscribe to Mike Will Travel. Definitely don't subscribe to Rob. On the other end, this is your sofa. It's actually a sofa bed, so you can easily pull it out, and you can sleep up to 2 additional guests in this corner. Next, let's head to the kitchen, which is very well equipped for a tiny home. You can find your microwave up top, and then your stovetop and oven below it. We'll go in further and you can find your fridge and freezer, and there's also a good amount of countertop space. I also love that backsplash with the white and blue tiling, and since we are in a rabbit-themed tiny home, they have this rabbit menu in the corner. After that, there are these 2 blue doors. The door closest to me is locked. I believe it's just a supply closet, so I go to this other one, which leads to the bathroom. The bathroom has all of these gorgeous white tiles throughout. You can see the sink and mirror there on the left, and Rob somehow even made the septic toilet sign look pretty. You have a small window as well, which lets in some natural light, and I loved all of the floor tiling. I definitely need to get the info for Rob's tile guy. The tiles are on the stairs as well. Speaking of which, let's go up top. This staircase is basically a rabbit art gallery. Rob did an amazing job at curating some very interesting rabbit artwork. My personal favorite is this one at the end. It looks like a Lucha Libre rabbit. I will round this final corner, and this takes us to the bedroom. You have a closet here, which is definitely nice because extra storage space is often tough to come by in tiny homes. There's also a full-size memory foam mattress, and I loved this corner. Definitely has that mid-century modern vibe to it. You can sit down here, or maybe also a great spot for the wife or girlfriend to touch up their makeup in that mirror. Finally, I'll open up this door, and this leads to your private outdoor deck. It faces in the direction of the sunset, and you also have all of those beautiful mountains there in the background. I'll finish off the video now with a quick section on cost. Rob built this place back in 2020, so please take into account these numbers are about 3 years old. I'm sure it would be much more expensive to build now in 2023. But the all-in cost came out to $165,000, including land. I'll put a link down to a video on Rob's channel in the video description where he chats a little more in depth about all of this. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.